Today we are going to be reading Rainbow Magic Special Edition Julia the Valentine Fairy. If you have the book, you can read along. You know, like Ben, I'm going to do a chapter. Walk the magic with him. Juliet the Valentine Fairy. Let's see. Here's all the spots in the book that we're going to be going through. So pretty much it's the map. Takes place there. Pretty much you go everywhere in it. It's Valentine's Day and love is everywhere. But I, Jack Frost, feel it isn't fair. Friends and families and sweethearts too. I've got a mean surprise for you. This holiday is no longer nice. If you celebrate, you will pay the price. Giving cards and gifts are a big mistake. These things will cause your heart to break. Okay, chapter 1, late for a date. Christy Tate paced from the front hall to the kitchen and back again. She pulled aside the curtain and looked out the window. There was still no sign of her best friend, Rachel Walker. Christy glanced at the grandfather clock in the corner and sighed. The Valentine workshop had already started. Why was Rachel so late? Christy stared out the window, hoping the Walker's Amalar station wagon would magically appear. But she knew that she couldn't just make magic happen. The truth was, she and Rachel knew a lot about magic. They had learned about it from their good friends, the fairies. The two girls had first met on a trip to Rainspell Island. There they helped seven rainbow fairies who had been sent away from Fairyland by the wicked Jack Frost. Rachel and Christy made a great team. King and Queen of Fairyland came to rely on the girls. Whenever Jack Frost and his goblins were causing trouble, Christy was happy that the fairies could trust them. And she knew she could trust Rachel too. She couldn't help smiling when she spotted the station wagon turning down the street. The car pulled up into the Tate's driveway. Rachel waved cheerfully to Christy, who hurried out to help her with the friend's bag. Rachel kissed her mom goodbye. "Hello, Christy," Mrs. Walker said. She turned back to her daughter. "Rachel, please call me and let me know what time I should pick you up on Saturday." Rachel nodded and waved as her mom drove off. "I'm so glad you're here," Christy said, hugging the best friends. "I started to worry." Rachel frowned and titled her head to the side. "We'll just put your bag in my room and go straight to the art center." Christy continued, "But I thought the Valentine workshop was after dinner," Rachel said, looking confused. "No," Christy replied. She couldn't help feeling a little annoyed. "But we should still have time," she added, hopefully. "Let's just tell my dad we're ready to go." The two friends dropped Rachel's bag upstairs and then headed to the kitchen. Through the window over the sink, they could see Christy's father working in the backyard. Christy poked her head out the back door. "Dad, can you take us to the art center now?" she asked. "Rachel's here." Mr. Tate looked up from the pile of wood and chicken wire. "Hi, Rachel," he called. Then he wiped his forehead with his sleeve and looked at Christy. "I completely forgot I was supposed to take you girls to the class. So nice that I started making the new compost bin for your mom." She glanced down at the pile. He glanced down at the pile of building supplies and furrowed his brow. "I still have a lot to do. I've made a big mess. Do you think you girls could ride bikes to the art center?" "Could we?" Okay, let's Christy felt a frown tug the corners of her mouth. She had left her dad a note. Why did he forget? And how would she ever make a Valentine's card with so little time? She wanted to be angry with him, but then she looked at the blue sky and sighed. It is very nice out for February, she admitted. Rachel nodded in agreement. I'll pick you up afterwards. And we'll put the bikes in the trunk, Mr. Tate said. Okay, the workshop is over at 6:30, replied Christy. See you then, Mr. Tate gave his daughter a warm smile. Someone we can jump on. And watched as she grabbed her friend's hand and ran back out the back inside the house. You can ride my new bike, Christy offered as they skipped down the garage steps. She pointed to a purple road bike with a green straw backrest in front. Once Rachel strung her leg over the bar and had one foot on a pedal, Christy grabbed the handlebars of a yellow bike with pink flowers on it. This was my cousin's. It's a little small, but I can still ride it, Christy said. She grinned. I bet I can beat you there. Thank you for listening to Chapter 1 of Juliet the Valentine Fairy. And we'll see you next time. Don't forget to like and subscribe, give a thumbs up or thumbs down, and do a comment down below about it, and we'll see you next time. Thanks for watching.